Welcome to Analytics with Nux. This is a quick trick on how to append or combine multiple data into a single table. If you are familiar with SQL, then you might have done union or union all operation for combining two different data sets into a single data set. So that is what we are going to do it right now. Let's see it in an example. We are exploring a Power BI using this business scenario, Naga Garments. If a person is owning a shop or a garments like this, and he wants to build a dashboard, and what are the different business scenarios he will encounter, and when he use appropriate options in Power BI? That is what we are exploring in this series. So this Naga Garments has branches in Chennai, Bangalore, and Hyderabad. Now, they have introduced a new store in small town where all these metropolitan cities are connected via a single point of sale system. Whereas this new small town doesn't have any internet or any other some facilities. So they maintain the data only in Excel. At the end of each day, they send it to via email to the business owners. And they have to match the point of sales data along with this small town data. So in this case, they need to use append or union operation to combine the data to analyze in a single data set. Let's see it in a demo. So we already have this dashboard built from a POS system over here. Now we need to get the data from the Excel, that is from the small town table. Then we need to append these two tables. Then we get the location information here so that we can analyze that information together in this dashboard. Let's see how to do it. Let's go to navigate that file, and I stored in Excel. So it's called data. Let us transform the data. So now the thing is, like, you need to combine these two data. And some people, if you ask me, like, why can't we have data in two different places? So now previously you see the dashboard built based on this. If you have your data over here, you need to create another dashboard or another fields that sales amount, it is separated. You understand it. So the sales price for this location is different and you cannot analyze with this same data in the same data level. So that is why you need to combine it. So along with this data, you can also analyze with other filters as well. That is the main important thing. You need to combine in a single place. So how to do that? So there is an option called append queries. Go to here, and this one is append queries as new. This I would suggest if you are not build a dashboard, then you can go for it, append queries as new, so that it will create a new table. From that, you can create the dashboard. If already you have built the dashboard, then I would suggest go for this, append queries. Go to here. Then concatenate rows from two tables into single table. So maybe data table to append, okay, sorry. So which table, based on which table you have built a dashboard, click on that table, then go to append queries, then choose data, table to append. So this data will be appended here. So now the data is appended. To ensure that, go and check the data here. Now you see the SurampAid data has came here. Earlier there was only three locations. Now this data also came here. Now you no need to load this particular data in your reporting side. So just click on disable unload. I mean, if you uncheck it, it will not load, but it will load here. Okay, that will not load in your report side. So I'm just clicking close and apply. There you go. So once you just pressing on, apply, then your new location is came into place. Now the business owner, the garment shop owner, can analyze as soon as possible. He got that Excel data into here, the new location. This is how you can keep incrementing your locations, and your dashboard, existing dashboard won't get affected. So this is one of the important factor you need to append your data. To append two data sets, the thumb rule is like in both the data sets, the column should be the same. I mean, the names, everything. What I mean by here is this is from the point of sales. It contains sale date, receipt number, order type, name, item name. And when you are getting this data from the file or any other source system, the columns in this table and in this table should be same. Before appending, then the orders, you need to ensure the column name, everything is same. Okay, and assume like you are getting something like bill number, and before that append step, you need to rename it. Always you can go here and change the steps. So if you want to rename it something, you can add some rename column, then append it. So just this is for your understanding, the column names in both the tables, if you are appending, should be the same. And one last point I want to highlight is like this append will do union all. Meaning those who are familiar with SQL, they might be aware of this term union all. Will retain the duplicates, meaning like you have some record over here having a similar record, so 06BL2. So this union all will keep the duplicates. So in order to remove those duplicates, after that we need to do a final step after append. Okay, select all the columns, then click on remove duplicates. Where is that? Hold on. You can right click, then remove duplicates. That will remove duplicates. That will make your union operation. So for this business scenario, there won't be a chances of duplicate. But assume like if you have in your business scenario to know about the concept, what append will do. Okay, that is why I highlighted this one. I hope you guys like this video. Do subscribe to this channel if you haven't done yet to see the tips and tricks like this. And do remember that data is your asset.